Hi. So of course you have all watched the Mac keynote and everyone is talking about the new text-to-vector functionality in Illustrator, but which went unnoticed is this one, Illustrator for the Web Beta, which is kind of remarkable because there is a nice feature in it. So let's take a look at it. Let's first take a look at the requirements, and you find them on the Illustrator System Requirements webpage. So here's Illustrator on the Web, and this is the requirements section. And you see, it's quite advanced what it wants to have. And unfortunately, you can't use it on Android, so you can't use it on a Chromebook. It's for Windows and Mac OS, and it has support for Chrome and Microsoft Edge, so Safari is not mentioned in here. And so let's use it. Let's go there. And we just enter that web page, or from the requirements page, you can also just click on the link. And then you can go there. Of course, in order to use it, you need to have a subscription for Illustrator or the Creative Cloud. This is the main page, and if you have never used Illustrator before, then you can use this nice introduction, which is an Illustrator file, and it has some instructions for you to do in order to get acquainted with everything vector. If you have used vector apps before, then of course there's nothing new in it for you. And if you have used Illustrator on the iPad, then this is quite straightforward. But if you haven't used Illustrator on the iPad, then you might find something very different to the desktop versions. So what can you do from here? There are down here your Creative Cloud files, and you can use them. I'm going to do that later to see what Illustrator on the Web does with objects it can't use. And then, of course, you can also create completely new files. You can use these templates in here, but when you do so, then everything gets set up for you. And if you want to set up everything to what you need precisely, then I would suggest you go to New File, because then you have full control. So let's just go to New File, and there you see you can enter everything. It has some templates here. And of course you want to control the color mode, and Illustrator on the Web can create files in RGB or CMYK color mode. And this is why it's important to use this dialog box, because then you can set that up and you cannot change it later. So if you want CMYK color, then you do it here. And then also you can set up this and set this up in the size you need. So let's set this up like so and get A4 document. And then also you see here are all templates, popular dimensions and everything you need. Let's create this file. And once you have created it, it gets saved to the cloud. So you can't just close this file and say, well, I don't need it. Let's get rid of it. It will be in the cloud and you have to delete it from there. Up here, you have some infos for the document settings. You can rename this file. You can go to the document settings and you see there you have the change of units, but you cannot change the color mode. So this is a CMYK file. Now, here we have a short menu for the file settings. So you can create a new file, open a file and save this. It gets saved regularly, but if you want it saved, then of course you should do so and use that save shortcut. Then you have access to the settings, which are the preferences. So you can set up the color theme and the size of icons, etc. And you can set up how the input works and how to use brushes, the units, your account, and then you can get help here. So there's a user guide. But you can go to help also over here. So there's a help icon, and there you also have access to the shortcuts, the user guide, the support community, and you can get rid of that by clicking on that icon again. On the left side, we have the tools, the toolbar, and there is the selection tool, the direct selection tool. Here we have two pen tools. So there's the standard pen tool, and there we have a quick pen tool, which is somewhat different. You see, it has this pop-up, and that can also be moved, and then you can use this like so, drawing polygons. You see these little triangles at the anchor points, and these mark the start and the end point of the path. You can also create arcs with it, which works like so. And then you can create pointed arcs, which is corner points in between all these arcs, and then create this kind of thing. So that's what this specific pen tool is about. Then we have a pencil tool, which works like the standard pencil tool, and a blob brush, eraser, and then you can also set type and vertical type, and you can create area type as well as point type by clicking here. You can create new artboards with this tool, like so, and you can change the size of the active artboard, but you can also create new ones. And with this one, you can place images. Down here, we have the settings for fill and stroke. You can click on that and click get the color picker. Up here, you select the type of color. So you can have solid color, and then you can also set up gradients in here. Linear gradients, as well as radial and freeform gradients. And you can set them like so and set up those gradient stops, move them around, set the color for them, and get this type of gradient here. It also works like so that you can set the radius and set the opacity for that stop. Then we have the CMYK input, and you can click here and show the sliders as well. And down here we have swatches, which can be shown as a grid or a list. And with that button, you create a new swatch. The same goes when you click on the stroke color. Over here, we have some commands to use. So up here, you can undo and redo, and then we have layers up there. You can create new layers in there. We have properties, and they show you the properties of the selected object. So there might be different things in here. And there you can set up everything. You can also set up arrowheads in there. Then we have the grid and rulers and all that stuff. The comments also work in here, so you can have a workflow with your colleagues to comment on your artwork. Then we have some Pathfinder operations in here. So we have the compound shapes here, and they create groups that have this applied as Pathfinder effects. And if you want to expand that to get real shapes, then you have to convert it to paths. Divide all creates paths immediately. So if you have some objects here, and then you can use divide all, then it divides them immediately. It's now a group first. So first of all, you need to ungroup that, which is in that strip that is shown beside every object, and then you can use that like so. Here we have the alignment. Down there we have some commands for creating compound paths, outline strokes, and such like. You can also make clipping masks. Here we have some things for types. So there you can also create type on a path. Now, if you have a path and then you have that text, you can select them both. And then you can make type on a path. So that's how that works. Let's just get that here. There is the type on the path, like so. You can also outline the text. And then here we have some commands for paths, which of course you know. And down there we have the repeat function, and you can also create blends because blends are just fantastic. Now, you might have thought, well, I didn't mention the shapes because that is the surprise. So here we have shapes. You can draw rectangles, and you see you can also change the corners, and you can have ellipses, and here is a polygon, and you see they are live shapes. And then we have stars. And what's that? This is a live star. So Illustrator on the Web has live star shapes, which is just fantastic. You can round them. Let's zoom in here. So you can round them. You can change this indent. You can change the number of points. And it's just great. Now let's get to this context sensitive toolpad, which is down here by every object that is selected. And in there you find commands that are not present in the toolbar, not in the menu, and not to the right in those menus. One of them is, for instance, grouping. So if you have several objects selected, then you can use this for grouping the objects. There's also opacity, which you can access in the properties panel, but it's also accessible here, and you can change stroke widths. And you can also change the stacking order with these commands or move these things around and lock them or delete them. Deleting also works by just hitting the delete key, but the main thing in there when you are looking for it is, of course, grouping.